Thank you very much, Martin. And it's a pleasure for me to come here today and tell you a little bit about sustainability in the global community as I and we see it at Novozymes. It's very much a biotech perspective which we come from. If you look at the globe as it is today, then we have a growing population and everybody has an aspiration for a better life. If you look at the way we live in the Western world, we are roughly 600-700 million people living at very high standards. We have 1.3 billion Chinese, 1.3 billion Indians, all aspiring to have the same standard of living as we have in the Western world. And this, of course, puts tremendous pressure on food, natural resources, and our climate. On top of this, we are around 6 to 7 billion people right now. The forecast for 2050 is that we are going to be 9 to 10 billion people. And obviously this even further puts pressure on these raw materials. And if you look at it as it is today, then the society is completely dependent on oil. All the products, more or less, you see on this slide, are directly linked to oil. Do you know what cost component in your laundry detergent is directly linked to the price of oil? 80% of the cost when you do laundry is directly linked to the cost of oil. And obviously, that's the way we do it in the Western world. There are still areas in the world where you wash in the local stream and where it's a full day job to do your laundry. These are, there will happen big changes, and there's absolutely no doubt that all the products you see on this slide, we will not be able to make in eternity as using oil as a resource. So this is a huge challenge. Then a small step back, tell you a little bit about what is Novozymes for a company, because of course in Denmark we consider ourselves as being known, but we realize that even though we are a medium-sized Danish company, outside Denmark we are not a very well-known company. But we actually have a very nice position in within biotechnology. We make industrial enzymes and microorganisms. We are the global market leader. We have 47% market share globally. The biggest competitor until recently was Danisco, another Danish company with around 21%. They were just acquired by the American company DuPont for 36 billion Danish kroner. And I guess this contributes a little bit to that some of the chemical industry have started to see that we cannot continue to source all our raw materials from oil or oil-derived products. We need to rethink how we are sourcing a lot of stuff. Being in charge of R&D, I have a very nice task. I use around 14% of the company's turnover. We are roughly 1,000 people in the R&D, and we are growing quite dramatically these days. We are growing in Denmark, and we are growing outside Denmark. It's a global organization with 9 locations across the world. As we are in the forefront of technology, we file a lot of patents, and we do actually make a fair portion of new products. And we do also make a quite nice profit, as our operating margin is 21.3%. And that's, I think, where you can say sustainability and economical profit goes hand in hand. If you are not sustainable if you don't make a profit or two. And obviously, I've been part of this business for many, many years. I was hired as a young engineer more than 27 years ago. And those days when you talked about renewable resources and sustainability, people didn't really understand what it was. That starts to happen. So sustainability at Novozymes is that we actually have a measurement on how much CO2 emission do we save the world for every year. And in 2010, the use of Novozymes products saved the world for around 40 million tons of CO2 emission. That's actually more than the entire Danish society has to save as a result of the Kyoto Protocol. We are rated as the leader in the biotech sector and gold class member of in the SAM Sustainability Yearbook. And the sustainability is a very integral part of what we supply. And we don't take projects into the pipeline unless we are sure that it will reduce our impact in terms of either energy reduction, reducing of chemicals, or less use of water. And then on top of this, we signed the Global Compact, United Nations Global Compact, and do actually try to in every, all we do to make the better utilization of the resources we have. We do that within a number of products. You use our product every single day. You maybe don't realize it, but I can tell you, you do. Either within household care, biorefining, food and beverage, microorganisms for fertilizers or for cleaning up special locations, biopharmaceutical, feed, leather and textile. Novozymes operates in more than 30 different industries as a B2B company, but it ends up in as you and me being the customer every single day. The largest area still is the way we work with detergents and household care. And there the task is really to reduce the consumption of energy and the pollution of water. Enzymes have the really nice feature that they are catalytic, meaning that you use minute amounts. So you better take care when you dose your laundry to secure that you have a few granules of enzyme in there, because that is really what is doing a large proportion of the job for you. When you really want to reduce temperature in your washing cycle, you need enzymes. If you really want to replace surfactants made by petrochemicals, then you have to put in more enzymes. When I started as a scientist also in the laundry area, we were happy if we could sell one enzyme to to many of the detergent makers. These days, the most advanced detergents, they have 8 different enzymes, and it won't stop there. In the old days, we had a dream that one day we will make an all-biological detergent. I don't know if that will happen in my lifetime, but it will for sure be the right development. And as I told you, oil dependence is very, very high on in detergent, so enzymes will actually reduce that and take it to a minimum. One of the real large areas is what we call biorefining and reducing our dependence on oil. It could be energy, but it could for sure also be use the waste we have from the agricultural production to use that carbon as building blocks for new chemicals, new polymers, new products we need in this society. Personally, I'm not too keen on the fuel programs because I don't like very much the way we use fossil fuels for personal transportation. The combustion engine is, of course, a nice device for making heat, but for personal transportation, it's not very smart. I hope that we find other solutions for personal transportation in the future, so we don't need to use our carbon resources from agricultural production to just burn them in combustion engines. But again, time will show. It's very dependent on our ability to actually go towards what we believe is the future, the bio-based society. This is a dream for me and for many of my colleagues at Novozymes, that one day we will be able to make a carbon neutral loop, that we can actually not just make all the products on the right side of this slide from renewable resources, but that we can also recirculate a large proportion of these. It's in, at least in theory, it's possible. Today, actually, around 5 to 10% of what we use is coming from renewable resources. I think it's realistic that within the next 30 years, 50% of this can be sourced from renewables, provided that we don't use all these nice carbon atoms to burn them either in heating devices or in cars. Again, of course, this is not happening automatically. You need to invest a lot in R&D. There's a lot of the basic processes which are not known and not developed at this point in time, but for sure they can be developed. Another example, and the example where we save the world for the most CO2, is actually to reduce how much bread we discharge. Roughly 20% of all the wheat we make today, that goes, we waste that because the bread turns stale or it turns moldy, and we don't utilize our resources efficiently. We sell enzymes which can prevent the bread from turning stale. And that's an area where you then will have much less waste. And when we look at microorganisms, then you can actually use microorganisms as fertilizer. You can release phosphate from the ground to the plants when you put on the right type of microorganisms in the field. One day, maybe, we can also replace all the nitrogen fertilizer we spread in the fields by making a much more efficient and smarter nitrogen fixation in the field using microbes for this. So there are plenty to go for. And that will both reduce fertilizers, but we can also reduce pesticides and even go to higher yields. And these are all things which we need to do. Also, reducing the cost within wastewater, microorganisms can be used. We have been running trials actually at this campus, or the wastewater from this campus, over the last 2 years to improve the way the membrane cleaning devices are working. And there's absolutely no doubt that the flux over these membranes can be greatly enhanced. This is still very, very early days, but we have very solid evidence that we can reduce how the membranes they clog, and meaning that you get a much higher benefit of these membranes when you clean water. So all in all, on every single industry we operate in, we do monitor how much CO2 do you save each time you use a kilo of enzyme. And typically it takes 1 to 10 kilo of CO2 to produce 1 kilo of enzyme. But these are the different industries, and you see animal feed is the lowest. There you only save roughly 10 kilos. But if you see in the baking area, each time you use 1 kilo of enzyme, you save 4 tons of CO2 emission. In average, when you take all Novozymes products, then you save between 150 and 200 kilos of CO2 per kilo enzyme we produce, if you take the average number. And we produce around 300,000 tons of enzyme, and that's what leads to these 40 million tons of saved CO2 on an annual basis. So for me, there's absolutely no doubt. Nature has made a lot of solutions for us. We just need to figure out how to use these the smartest possible way. Then we will definitely be able to live a much more sustainable life. But there's no doubt that there's also a lot of hard work in front of us, because it's not happening without a lot of engineers, a lot of scientists are doing their utmost to secure that all these things are made possible. Thank you for your attention.